How do you solve the problem of energy storage? Solar and wind energy are some of the keys to a more sustainable future, one without CO2 emissions, and for reducing the risk of energy shortages. But they're almost useless unless we solve the important problem of energy storage. When green energy supply matches demand, everything's fine. But when supply is at its peak, and we don't need all of that energy, we actually don't know how to store it. So we have to cap production. In Switzerland, for example, consumption is at its peak in the winter. We should store the energy produced in the summer and use it in winter when we need it the most. For a small country like Switzerland, it's estimated that 7 terawatt hours are needed in storage to avoid a deficit in winter. 7 terawatt hours corresponds to 4 times the energy production of the Grand Exance, the tallest dam in Switzerland, or 69.3 million Tesla batteries. But there is another solution. It involves a system of renewables: hydrogen production, carbon capture, and methane production. By using the chemical process of electrolysis, green energy can be converted into hydrogen. What is electrolysis? In a nutshell, it's using catalysts to split water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen, and then storing the hydrogen molecules. These hydrogen molecules can be stored for a sufficiently long time and could provide energy. However, there is a problem. This storage is expensive and complicated because hydrogen molecules are volatile and escape easily. Also, a share of energy is lost in the conversion of hydrogen back into electricity. To solve this problem, hydrogen can be combined with carbon dioxide to transform water molecules into methane. This is called methanation. This is not a simple process, but it allows green energy to be stored for as long as desired without too much difficulty. Moreover, the CO2 needed for methanation is abundantly available thanks to emissions from human activities. It turns out that we're able to capture CO2 using graphene membranes. Metallic organic frameworks, or MOFs, capture it and the membranes filter it. Such a system is feasible and several of the components exist. However, there is still a long way to go, especially in terms of cost. We're still at the research stage, but researchers are doing their best. They're testing the system on a small scale with demonstrators before hoping to be able to one day supply an entire country.